Hi, guys. Thank you for joining me. I'm sure a lot of you have heard about the man that flew into the United States with monkeypox. 27 states are monitoring people who may have come in contact with a man that came in from Nigeria, and at least over 200 people are being watched. I have to wonder, was this a disease that was created by man? Monkeypox was first discovered in 1958 when two outbreaks of pox-like disease occurred in colonies of monkeys kept for research. The first case of monkeypox was recorded in 1970 in the Democratic Republic of Congo during a period of intensified effort to eliminate smallpox. Monkeypox belongs to the same family of viruses as smallpox. According to the CDC, in humans, the symptoms of monkeypox are similar but milder than the symptoms of smallpox. You have a 10% chance of dying from monkeypox. The illness begins with fever, headache, muscle aches, backache, swollen lymphoids, chills, and exhaustion. Within 1 to 3 days, sometimes longer, the appearance of fever, the patient develops a rash, often beginning on the face, then spreading to other parts of the body. Lesions progress through the following stages before falling off, and they got different things listed here, including scabs. The illness typically lasts 2 to 4 weeks. In Africa, monkeypox has been shown to cause death in as many as 1 in 10 persons who contracted the disease. The man evidently flew in and landed at Atlanta, Georgia Airport. Why were they not screening for fevers? Last time they screened for fevers was from the threat of Ebola. Those that were on the flight with him are being watched closely around the country. Supposedly, while on the flight, people were required to wear masks. Monkeypox can be transmitted through the air and on objects, so I have to wonder about the baggage carriers there at the airport. People who might have handled the tickets while transferring from Atlanta to Texas. He flew on to Texas from Atlanta, Georgia. How long was his layover there in Atlanta, Georgia? Did the man venture into other parts of the airport? Did he eat while there? How many other people there that work at the airport came in contact with the man? How many of those people that worked at the airport took the shuttle service that's available there? Here we have an image of the airport right along the interstate. On our vacation to Orlando, Florida, we passed through there going and coming back. The traffic was horrendous, giving you an idea just about how many people live and work in that area. Yeah, it was bumper to bumper and people switching lanes, going back and forth. Yeah, it was amazing. But think about all those people that work at the airport that live in the surrounding communities. And yeah, this image of the traffic should give you an idea. Yeah, it was amazing, the amount of traffic. You know, I lived in San Francisco for a number of years. I would say it's probably comparable. This here is an image of us coming back, going through the city, coming up to the downtown area. And it was early, probably about 9, 10 o'clock in the morning. Probably after rush hour. Another image taken from the video. Yeah, bumper to bumper traffic. This here is an image of Emory Hospital. They also have Georgia Tech, Georgia University there. According to the CDC, the man was confirmed in mid-July, a Texas man who traveled from Lagos, Nigeria to Atlanta. The CDC is monitoring over 200 people that the man had contact with and asked them to quarantine for about 3 weeks. Severe cases can be treated with antiviral drugs such as cidofovir. However, the use of antivirals is off-label as it has not been extensively tested in humans with a monkeypox virus. Evidently, what it's been used for is for eye infections, viral infections of the eyes, from AIDS patients. A previous monkeypox outbreak in the U.S. in 2003 infected 47 people. It was linked to animals such as rodents and prairie dogs that were delivered to pet shops, where people were likely infected by handling the shedding of those animals, the shedding of the virus. In my opinion, it's pretty dumb not to at least take temperature tests of people returning, coming into the country. Why aren't they doing that? It's like playing Russian roulette. Have they even thought about the ticket holders, the baggage people, when they transferred his luggage from one plane to another? Or the other parts of the airport? More than likely, he did have a layover. What are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. You don't know what it could come, what form it could come in. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.